Welcome to the Cozy Noah Vibes. I'm your host, Nina. Thank you for choosing to join us. Before we begin, find a comfortable position and set aside all tasks. Let's enter a state of calm together. First, let's take a deep breath. Inhale slowly. Then exhale gently. Repeat a few times. Deepen and regulate your breath. Now use your senses to feel every part of your body. Notice any tension or discomfort. Simply acknowledge their presence. Don't try to change them. As you continue to breathe deeply, let's gradually release the tension in your body. Starting from the head and moving downward, gently releasing each muscle. Feel the comforting lightness. We also read a small plastic snake and a big toy frog for the chance. Gently embracing you, shift your focus to your thoughts. Don't try to eliminate them. Just let them drift by quietly, like clouds drifting in the sky. You are merely an observer, unaffected by these thoughts. Let's take another deep breath, absorbing the peaceful and serene energy. In this moment, you are safe and tranquil. Anything can wait until tomorrow. Thank you for participating in tonight's scientific relaxation moment. May you have a peaceful night now as you drift off to sleep. We also need a small plastic snake and a big toy frog for the chance. Hephaestus. The son of Zeus and Hera was abandoned by his vain mother Hera due to his ugly appearance and inherent disability. As an adult, he was robust and skilled in blacksmithing. In revenge against his heartless mother, he crafted a magnificent throne with hidden mechanisms out of gold and gifted it to Hera. When she sat on it, she found herself immobilized. Eventually, Dionysus, the god of wine, intoxicated him. And with his help, Hephaestus returned to rescue Hera in his wondrous forge. Hephaestus crafted exquisite weapons and ornaments. Often mediating disputes among the gods and subduing formidable foes with his fiery power and wind hammer. As the god of fire and craftsmanship, he brought warmth and miracles to people. Yet his wrath was also fearsome. Hephaestus, the god of fire and craftsmanship, was the son of Zeus and Hera, born on the radiant Mount Olympus. Unrivaled in the art of blacksmithing, he was born weak and lame. When the goddesses presented this ugly and feeble son to the gray Hera, she was furious. Seizing him, she cast him from Mount Olympus to the distant. The unfortunate infant drifted in the air for a long time before plummeting into the boundless waves of the sea. The daughters of the mighty Oceanus, the sea god Eurynome, and the prophetic old sea god Nereus' daughter Thetis took pity on him. They lifted the fallen Hephaestus from the sea and carried him to the depths below the gray ocean. There, in a bright cavern, they nurtured Hephaestus. The lame god Hephaestus grew up strong, with powerful hands, broad chest, and sturdy muscles. What a marvelous artist he became in the craft of blacksmithing. The goddesses Eurynome and Thetis. He fashioned many splendid ornaments of gold and silver. Hephaestus nursed a grudge against his birth mother Hera for casting him from Mount Olympus. And finally, he decided to exact revenge. He crafted an exquisitely beautiful throne out of gold and presented it to Hera as a gift. The wife of the thunder god was delighted to see such a magnificent throne. Indeed, only the queen of gods and mortals deserved such a marvelous seat. But, alas, it was dreadful. The moment Hera sat on the throne, unseen cords bound her tightly, rendering her immobile. The gods rushed to her raid, but their efforts were futile. None had the strength to free the Queen Hera. It became clear that only Hephaestus, the creator of the throne, could release his great mother. The gods immediately sent the messenger god Hermes to implore the blacksmith god. Like a whirlwind, Hermes swiftly arrived at the shores of the vast ocean. In an instant, he descended into the depths of the sea to Hephaestus' workshop. For a long time, he beseeched Hephaestus to accompany him to mighty Mount Olympus to rescue Queen Hera. But the blacksmith god adamantly refused. Still resentful of his mother's actions, neither Hermes' pleas nor entreaties moved him. Dionysus, the choice god of wine, came to his aid, laughing heartily. He presented Hephaestus with bowls of fragrant wine, one after another, inebriated. Hephaestus was now pliant, willing to go wherever they led him. Hermes and Dionysus hoisted Hephaestus onto the back of a donkey and carried him to Mount Olympus. Hephaestus swayed unsteadily on the donkey's back as they journeyed. Menads, wearing ivy crowns and carrying thirsty, danced joyously around Hephaestus. Silenus drunkenly stumbled and frolicked about. Smoke billowed from torches, mingling with the clang of bronze cymbals. Bells and drums as laughter echoed to the heavens. The great Dionysus, wearing a crown of grapevines and ivy, led the procession amidst the revelry. They reached Mount Olympus. In the blink of an eye, Hephaestus freed his mother, and now he bore no grudge. Hephaestus remained on Mount Olympus, where he built majestic golden palaces for the gods and a palace of his own, adorned with gold, silver, and bronze. He dwelt there with his beautiful and gentle wife, the goddess Aphrodite. Hephaestus's forge was also within the palace. Hephaestus spent most of his time in his wondrous workshop. At its center lay a massive anvil, surrounded by smoldering furnaces and bellows blowing fiercely. These were magical bellows that operated at Hephaestus's command without the need for hands. With a word, they stoked the furnace flames to a blistering heat. The god of blacksmithing toiled in his workshop, covered in sweat, soot, and smoke. Hephaestus fashioned countless marvels and breakable weapons, golden ornaments, wine goblets, baldricks, and tripods that slid on golden wheels. After finishing his work, washed clean of sweat and ashes in fragrant baths, Hephaestus limped and swayed on his weak legs to his father Zeus, the thunder god, to join the gods' banquet. The kindly and loyal Hephaestus often intervened to prevent the impending quarrels of Zeus and Hera. When the gods saw the lame Hephaestus leisurely pouring them ambrosia and nectar at the banquet table, they could not help but laugh heartily. Laughter cast aside their disputes. However, the blacksmith god Hephaestus could also be fearsome. He had burned many gods with his fire and struck them fiercely with his dreadful hammer. Near Troy, even subdued the raging waves stirred up by the river gods Cammander and Semis with his fire. He defeated mighty titans with his terrifying hammer. Hephaestus, the god of fire and master craftsman, was a great deity who brought warmth and joy to people. He was kind yet faithful. But when punishment was due, he was formidable. As we conclude our time together, may the serenity of this moment linger with you through the night. You hold the power to create your own dreams. Filled with wonder and possibility, we also meet a small plastic slate and a big toy frog for the kids. Knowing that tomorrow holds endless opportunities for growth and joy. Until we meet again, sleep well and embrace the beauty of your own imagination. Good night and sweet dreams.